Okay, everybody, I think we're ready to get things underway. I'm glad everybody's getting a chance to say hello and welcome each other. If you can find you a place to sit down, we'll get the program underway and get to our lunch too. Hate to break it up, it's such a nice hubbub of talk and everybody's glad to see each other. We'll go ahead and get started with a program. My name is Brian Haygood. I'm Alamance County Manager, and on behalf of Alamance County Government, I'd like to thank you for making time to give us an opportunity to thank you, all you citizen volunteers, for the work that you do for Alamance County. It's significant to us as staff to have citizens volunteer to help us keep county government moving forward, and moving forward in a way that we can all live with. I think sometimes as staff, it's easy to become disconnected from the people that we serve, and you serve a vital role of keeping us connected to those people. When we're coming up with policies and program ideas, it's nice to have volunteers that work with us that help keep us grounded and plugged into what's going on in the real world. So thank you very much. Thank you for being here today. We hope that you realize this is because we appreciate what you do, and that it is very meaningful to county government. Before I go much further, I'd like to take an opportunity to recognize some special guests that we have with us here today. I'd like to recognize the chair of the Alamance County Board of Commissioners, Ms. Amy Galey's with us today. We also have County Commissioner Bob Byrd and his wife, Barbara. We're very pleased to have them here today. And we also have County Commissioner Mr. Eddie Boswell with us. And we're glad to have y'all join us today. And I think you're gonna have an opportunity to take part in the program too. And I'd also like to take just a moment to thank a couple of folks that have made this possible, all the food and the pretty decorations and the tables and everything that you see. Big thank you to Tori Frink. Tori's the county clerk, and she's been the spearhead of this program. I certainly appreciate it, and I know you do too. And I'd also like to thank Manon Frizzell. Manon is with the Alamance County Tax Office, and she has been instrumental in helping put all this together, and we appreciate her efforts too. So thank you. And Mr. Buddy Weitzel, Buddy's in the back. Buddy's with our County Facilities Department, and he helps with setup. And all these things come together to help make this the nice event that it is, and we appreciate that. So thank you. So I generally save all my long comments for county commissioner meetings, as I'm sure the county commissioners can attest to. So I won't take up any more of your time. At this time, I'd like to introduce Mr. Rodney Cheek. Rodney was the 2017 recipient of the Citizen Volunteer of the Year Award. Rodney serves as the chairperson of our Planning Board and our Historic Properties Commission. So we're glad to have Rodney back with us this year, and ask Rodney to come on up and maybe say a few words to the folks. So come on, no further ado. Come on up.
How you?
Just do your thing, whatever you like.
Well, let me start by saying, last year when I stood here, I had been married for 11 days. And my wife was in Haiti on a mission trip. So when Eddie Boswell invited me to speak, I was allowed to a little bit. Now I've been married for a year and 10 days, and my wife is here. And since I'm holding up lunch, she said, let's put it on some lunch. As I stood in this room last year, I was flummoxed as to how and why I had been chosen the Volunteer of the Year, particularly when I looked around and seen the other nominees. But whatever the reason it was, I was honored then, I'm honored to be here now. And as I've been this person for the year, I'm not sure that I've done anything that would warrant me having this award. But I have given just a little bit of thought to the people, the committee, the whomever that makes this decision. And that task has got to be daunting, particularly from the perspective when a person is sincere in their volunteer work, not everybody knows about it. So to go out and find a person that's doing this kind of stuff and make that determination, that's, I'm glad I wasn't charged with that job, let me just say that. But at any rate, as we look at this rotation over here, I do want to say that I have two sport coats. And as I was getting ready to come here today, I looked at both of them and I said, well, I got a 50-50 chance. So it looks like I only have one sport coat, but I actually have two. I'm done.
This time, introduce chairperson of the County Board of Commissioners from Sandy Gale.
Thank you. I'm here to say the blessing over the food. I know there are other people in our community who do that a lot better than I do, but I'm going to do it the Union Ridge way, okay? If you pray with me, please. Heavenly Father, we just take this opportunity to lift up our hearts to you with thanksgiving for these people here and for the opportunity to fellowship with one another. We thank you for this county, which we are honored to serve. We just pray that your hand of blessing would be on it. And as each of us enjoy this meal and go out today, that we would live our lives in the fullness of your service and in helping to bring your kingdom to the earth. And please bless this food for our bodies and our bodies to your service. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
So I personally would like it if you all would start and we work our way around and then our table go last. I think that that's the most appropriate thing. So if y'all would go ahead and get started with the rest of the program now. Next up is Commissioner Eddie Boswell. He's going to talk about our honorable mentions.
Very good. I get the honorable mentions here. And the first one I have today is Rena Bennett. Is she here?
Yes, she is.
Okay. Hey, okay. Very good. If you want, you can come on up here, Rena. I'm going to tell them a little bit about you. Want to know who I'm talking about? Or maybe you want to read this before I have you come up. Since 2014, Rena has been an active and involved member of the Adult Care Home CAC. She has served as secretary for the committee, and she also volunteers as a receptionist at the senior center. So, congratulations.
Thank you.
I guess they all get a pen, too. You get pen, too. I'm going to just hand you the whole folder there. And here we go.
Thank you.
Very good. Next, we have Wilma Jean Gaddison. And I think she goes by Jean.
Yes.
Jean has been a loyal and devoted member of the Adult Care Home CAC since 2015. She has served as secretary for the committee. Jean is very passionate about volunteerism as she has been a member of the AmeriCorps, which is a national service program. Yet Jean has worked diligently serving this community. Thank you very much. And last but not least is Miss Gail Pettifer. It's my honor to do Gail. I've known her from a carpentry class she took. Looked like she went out and did some work with that. So. Gail was first appointed to the Medin Planning Board as the county's ETJ member in June of 2002. To fill an unexpired term. She has served 16 years on that board and has continued to be recommended for reappointment each time her term was expiring. Gail has served on the county's Historic Property Commission since March of 2013 and Gail recently completed the 2018 Spring County Government Academy. Unfortunately, she had to miss that graduation because she was out using some of those skills that I taught her on a mission trip in Haiti, where she went to help build a new school. So when Gail is not busy serving the community, she still manages to work a full-time job.
Oh, wow.
Thank you.
All right, great. Well, it is my honor to talk about our volunteer nominees and then to announce the 2018 winner. So. First, we have Virginia Gail Miller. Gail Miller, who stepped down this past year from chairing the Alamance Planning Committee, remains involved as a senior Tar Heel legislator alternate delegate and is Community Advisory Committee volunteer. She is also actively working on a draft of the Alamance County Aging Plan and was instrumental in our committee's pursuit of radio spots on WBAG to let the county citizens know of our partner services for the aging population. And I was honored to participate in that, and that was great. This year, she has shown leadership in connecting us with filming some video spots featuring our partners and their services. Gail is very progressive and forward-thinking and actively tries to recruit new committee members as well as promoting awareness in the communities across the county. She has volunteered to staff a booth at recent help fairs to make citizens aware of what our Alamance County Planning Committee for Aging Services to the Elderly is doing in service to the county, has visited each of our partners to understand their services, and has invited others to the table to learn more about our responsibilities to the county. She has served as a positive ambassador for our committee in the communities and actively participates in our partners' fundraising events. She sought out the role of volunteering with the CAC in nursing homes to better serve and advocate those individuals in nursing facilities. The county has benefited from her active volunteerism and leadership. So, Gail, if you would come forward and get your certificate. Mr. Charles Ansel has actively served on the Voluntary Agriculture District Board for many years. He and his wife operate a small farm in the southern part of Alamance County and demonstrate a passion and love of the land. They demonstrate this passion by working with the County Agriculture Department, hosting farm workshops, and encouraging young people who show an interest in agriculture. Charlie regularly participates at the VAD meetings and has served on several subcommittees to provide leadership and guidance to the board to better the efforts in preserving farmland in the county. So if Charlie would come up. Is he here? I didn't think he was here. Okay. So we'll set this aside for him. Kelly May. Is Kelly here?
No,
okay. I didn't think so. Kelly has been a tremendous asset to the Recreation and Parks Commission for many years. She is engaged in the community and is always willing to help our department with her resources and time. She understands that our parks and programs are an important part of maintaining the quality of life that is important to families and to our economy. Our next recognition goes to Foxy Harper. Foxy, if you would come on up. Foxy is a longtime resident of Burlington, North Carolina. She has balanced family and community involvement and is always willing to go the extra mile. She has served in many capacities within her community. Her commitment to serving the people of Alamance County makes her an excellent candidate for this award. She currently serves as a volunteer on several committees that include the Community Advisory Committee, or CAC, where she serves as chair, the Alamance Planning Committee for Services to the Elderly, the Regional Advisory Council on Aging, and various committees within her church. Foxy has had such a positive impact on the senior citizens of Alamance. She is knowledgeable regarding community resources and how funding impacts seniors and persons with disabilities. As a leader, she helps educate others within her community regarding available resources, Medicare options, and the Home and Community Care Block Grant. As a Community Advisory Committee volunteer, she advocates on behalf of residents in long-term care and makes quarterly and yearly visits. Foxy tirelessly works toward keeping the public informed about aspects of long-term care and operations of Home and Alamance, all the while maintaining the intent of the residents' Bill of Rights. She is a giver of her time and talent, is an advocate who focuses on quality of life for our seniors and persons with disabilities. Foxy is a humble person who not only uses her gifts to serve, but also recognizes the contributions of others. So Foxy, thank you so much. Ashley Harris was also received a nomination. She's not here, but I'm going to read what she's up to. So Ashley Harris demonstrates a concern for the development of the community through all her activities and leadership positions. She serves as a volunteer basketball coach for young girls in the community in order to help provide them with a strong role model, as well as learn the ethics involved in getting along with others. She raises scholarship money for young girls desiring to attend college. Her positive image reaches out through this and many other service activities, such as food drives and collecting necessities for mentally ill clients at various facilities. She always finds a way to participate regularly in community committee projects despite her tight schedule. Ashley shows evidence of ongoing leadership and dedication by always looking for ways to help others while demonstrating a commitment to improving the quality of community life. She does these things with energy, leadership, commitment, and donates her time to enhance committee goals, programs, and initiatives while working a demanding full-time job and attending school for her PhD. Her skills are valuable, and her commitment to helping others stands well above others. Ashley manages to juggle all her interests with grace and poise. She deserves to be honored in this way with this award. So no wonder she's not here. She has done something. I'm humbled hearing all that. All right, Lee Isley. Lee, if you would come up. Lee faithfully attends the planning board meetings and is a valuable contributor. Lee is also a dedicated member of the Recreation and Parks Commission. Lee secured the donation of billboard space on the interstate corridor for the Hall River Trail and Cedar Rock billboards. He has volunteered as a coach in the youth athletics programs. Lee was nominated last year and has continued to be a tireless advocate for this community. And I don't see your certificate, Lee.
That's okay.
Did I put it up here? Oh, I did. That's my fault. That's I can't read. I'm sorry.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Thank you. Robbie Ballon. Robbie, if you would come forward, please. Robbie moved to Alamance County from Texas. He wanted to get involved and at the same time learn more about his community. He looked into boards to serve on and chose the Planning Board and the Historic Properties Commission. He worked with Rodney Cheek to develop uniform signage for Alamance County HPC for continuity. Robbie brings his fresh perspective to the HPC and reads all his material and asks pertinent and thought-provoking questions. He brings out details in the HPC discussions that might have otherwise be overlooked. Robbie is interested and respectful of Alamance County history. So thank you, Robbie, so much. All right, and I am absolutely delighted to announce that our 2018 Citizen Volunteer of the Year Award recipient is Mr. Earl Pickett. Earl Pickett has been a dedicated member of the Social Services Board since his 2017 appointment through the North Carolina Social Services Commission, whose mission is to promote closer working relationships between county boards and social services. Earl upholds the mission to increase public understanding, acceptance, and support of public assistance of social services programs. Earl has fulfilled and served in many capacities for Alamance County citizens. Mr. Pickett successfully completed the Alamance County Sheriff's Office Citizens Academy in 2016, as well as Alamance County Government Academy, to get a better understanding of the services that each county department provides to the community. Since his completion of these community training opportunities, Earl has been actively participating and advocating for the citizens of Alamance County. Earl is a member of the Child Protection and Fatality Prevention Team of Social Services, where he tirelessly gives his time reviewing cases and identifying gaps in services in our community. During multiple reviews of cases, Earl has facilitated donations for social service families who are in need through his local church, provided money for transportation for mother to transport her child back and forth to Duke Hospital. Mr. Pickett sits on the board of directors for the North Carolina Association of County Board of Social Services, where he was elected by the membership during the October 2018 annual meeting to serve as regional director for Region 2 that serves five other counties. In this work, Mr. Pickett advocates for system needs for all DSS agencies across the state. Earl continues to make himself available to mentor young males through Graham Middle School and has offered his services to our child welfare social workers on several occasions for other young men in need. As a social services board member, Earl is an advocate for social services, the citizens we serve, and Alamance County government.
Well, there's a saying in religious circles, you never give a minister a microphone. So I will keep mine short. But to the exemplary leadership of the Director of Social Services, Ms. Susan Osborne, to the wonderful staff, and to all you outstanding volunteers for whatever you do, wherever you do it for the citizens of Alamance County, I am just an example of what we can do as a whole. It takes all of us together to make our county a better place to live. Some of us are maturing in age. We won't see the fruits of our labor, but we can lay the foundation for those that are coming behind us. So once again, to keep it short, thank you so very much, Madam Chair, Mr. Haygood. It's good seeing both of you again. Thank you once again.
That is so awesome, and thank you again to all of our recipients, the nominees, and everybody, and just appreciate so much all that everybody in this room contributes so much to our community. Next, we're going to have Commissioner Bob Byrd with recognizing our volunteers and staff liaisons.
Thank you, Amy. And I look out at this room, and I think about our democracy and how fortunate we are in the United States to have such a democracy, because we really are a country that's run by the people, for the people. I forgot one of them. I'm the people. Government, thank you. And this past week, I was in an orientation session of new fellows, graduates of Elon, who are doing some fellowship work in the community, and part of that class was to learn about government. And so we had a few elected officials in the room and some appointed officials, and it was really I was awestruck by the complexity of our government. So we have federal government and state government and local government, and so many opportunities for people to participate in our government. And we have a dispersion of power. We don't have any place in our government where there's a concentration of power where somebody can just take over. We have all these checks and balances everywhere, you know, executive branch, judicial branch, legislative branch. So, but in this room is a great example of how we have citizen involvement in our government, and the way decisions get made, and just really good participation. So I just think it's really important. So I want to recognize each of the committees and boards that are here. And as I call the name of the committee, if you would just stand up, and we'll start with the first one, the Adult Care Home Community Advisory Committee, and Cynthia Moore. Did I say that right?
Yes,
Moyer, thank you, who is the with the Piedmont Triad Regional Council is the liaison. So everybody on that committee, would you please stand up? So that one is near and dear to my heart, because early in my career, I served for a few years on that committee. And then on this next one as well, the Nursing Home Community Advisory Committee, and Cynthia, once again, the liaison. So everybody on the Nursing Home Community Advisory Committee. And then the Planning Committee for Services to the Elderly, and the liaison is Teresa Jackson, Piedmont Triad Regional Council. Okay, who's here from the Alamance Beautiful Commission? Stand up, please. Nobody. Okay, the Board of Equalization and Review, and the liaisons are Jeremy Atkins and Manon Frizzell. So you all stand up, please. And then we have the Alamance County Planning Board and the liaisons, Sherry Hook and Teresa Harvey. So you all stand up. I guess just the liaisons are here today.
Stand up.
Rodney. Anybody else on the? Yeah, there we go. Thank you. Don't be bashful now. And then the Historic Properties Commission, and again, Sherry Hook and Teresa Harvey. Historic Properties Commission. There's just a couple more here. The Social Services Board, and Susan Osborne and Carmen Morrow, please stand up. And the last one, the Voluntary Agriculture District Board, and the liaisons Brad Moore and Monique McKinney. You all stand up. All right, I do want to give a special thanks to Manon Frizzell for the floral arrangements and to helping to organize this event. Thank you very much. And then if we have any 2018 Spring County Government Academy graduates, would you please stand up? And if you haven't been through that program, consider signing up next time, because it is really, really good. Did I miss one? Oh, Recreation and Parks Commission. I'm sorry. Who's here from Recreation and Parks?
We know.
And Brian Baker. Thank you, Tori, for pointing that out. Okay, Amy, I guess it's back to you.
Your bike tire.
All right, just a couple of closing remarks. I just wanted to piggyback off of what Bob said about the importance of volunteers and the importance of participation in public life. Super quick, in 1831, Alexis de Tocqueville came from France to the new United States. We'd only been in the country for 50 years. And the French government sent him to come and take a look at America and see what's going on. Why is it going so well so far after 50 years? And he wrote a book that was published in 1835 called Democracy in America. And in that he wrote, Americans of all ages, all conditions, all minds constantly unite. Not only do they have commercial and industrial associations in which they all take part, but they also have 1,000 other kinds, religious, moral, grave, futile, very general and very particular, immense and very small. Americans use associations to give parties, to found seminaries, to build inns, to raise churches, to distribute books, to send missionaries. In this manner, they create hospitals, prisons, schools. Finally, if it is a question of bringing to light a truth, for developing a sentiment with the support of a great example, they associate. So thank you so much for being part of that association of citizens concerned for the welfare and well-being of our community in Alamance County. Thank you for coming and spending this lunchtime with us, and I'm humbled to be part of working with you all. So here's a hand for you.